My name is Kaya Lee. I was diagnosed with aplastic anemia when I was 16, and I have had 2 bone marrow transplants. Aplastic anemia is basically when your body stops making blood. So that means you stop making red cells, you stop making platelets, you stop making white cells. So when I was 16 years old, I had an ovarian cyst burst. My mom brought me to the ER, and she works in the lab, and when I got my lab work back, we noticed that my platelet count was low. Something was off, and it was off for me looking back at my old lab work that I had had for routine checkups. When I first heard the diagnosis, it was kind of the start of my life changing. At that point, I think I was going for lab work twice a week, sometimes 3 times, and slowly watching all of my counts go lower and lower. What many people do is go into crisis mode. We watched it and we were prepared and we were where we needed to be. And as soon as my counts dropped into the severe level, then I went inpatient for my transplant. So before both of my transplants, I needed chemotherapy to basically wipe out my immune system. When my sister Tara found out that she was my one and only family match, she did not think twice. She said, absolutely. When do you need me? What time? I'll be there. It's strange to think because I watched this bag holding my life in it, which is so strange. Like I tell people like, no, I was literally holding my life in my hands. Every day, your white blood count is at less than 0, less than 0, less than 0, because they've wiped you totally out with the chemo. And then that first day where you get that 0.1, it's like, oh, things are growing in there. Like I'm actually building up an immune system. Pretty soon I'm turning into this normal person again, but it was challenging going to school, going to college. I found out that I had chemo brain, which made school extremely difficult. I could not pay attention, and I was stopping 300-person lectures for the instructor to tell me to quit disrupting class when I had no idea that I was. Things were great until January of 2013, I relapsed. The reason I needed a second transplant was because the lighter chemo from my first transplant left some of my cells still in my body, and that is like rejecting an organ. And my life has since revolved around blood work. It was follow-ups, 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 checking more and more and more for all these things until finally I was building somewhat of an immune system. Again, the accurate numbers were so helpful for my team. They knew when to admit me. It allowed them to be so proactive instead of reactive, which is everything in a transplant scenario. Now I feel like a normal person, which I always love to say because, of course, my story isn't normal and there are some things that aren't normal. I wanted this and I can't believe that I actually got here. Looking back at my whole medical journey, I can say now that I'm so proud of myself. And now I feel like I finally have this plan for the rest of my life. The lab results and tests might seem intimidating, but I hope people feel like they can ask why. Why was this test done? What does this test mean? How can this change from when I got that exact test before from now? What does this change mean? Without laboratory professionals and pathologists doing their job to that high of a standard, I know that I wouldn't be alive.